Hello friends, welcome back to Getting Yourself Organized with Org Mode, my little screencast about Org Mode. Today we have a video, we look at the function of attachments. The goal is we want to attach some files to our tasks. And the receipt for that is quite easy because Org Mode has a sort of attachment subsystem and you call it with Control C, Control A. What you need to know in advance is attachments are stored under a data directory inside your directory that holds the org file. So if you, let's see in a shell view, you see this is my org file and there is no data directory yet because I don't have any attachments in my file until now. So when you open your attachment system, one thing you can do is you could set a specific directory for your attachments, but that's something I really don't do because I rely on the standard structure that is based on the ID property that every task has. And you can also set, and that's something I want to do now, you can set an inherit flag that says if you have a sort of project structure and you say I want all my files for this project in one attachment directory, then you can go to the upper level and you call the attachment subsystem Control C, Control A, and you press I for the inherit flag and you see you get the property attached to inherit. So we are practically well prepared for that. You can still see if I'm looking at my files, there is no data directory yet. I have to attach a file. So if I want to attach a file, I do the same. It's Control C, Control A. No, it was the wrong buffer. Sorry, I have to be here. I have to go to this entry. I want to attach the org mode reference card. It's Control C, Control A, and now you can choose which method you want to use for attaching. There are four possible methods. One is that you copy the file from where it's now to your attachment directory. The next one would be moving. Copy is C, moving is M. Then you could copy it by creating a hard link. But the hard link is something that works on Linux file systems like X234 and so on, but it probably won't work on Windows. And the same is for the Y, attach the file by creating a symbolic link. That's also not available on all file systems. The difference between a hard link and a symbolic link is that your hard link is practically a copy of your of your directory entry that points to the same data space on your hard disk. So you have two files under maybe two different names, but they are stored in the same area of your hard disk. So if you added one, you also added the other one. And the symbolic link is more like a pointer, that's a short file that says, okay, the file that you are looking for is placed on another place. So for my example now, let me just copy a file and he wants to ask me, where do you have your file that you want to have as an attachment? I have downloaded a file to the temp directory before that is called org card PDF. So now I have this attachment org card PDF. You see I get a property that says attachment and I get a property here. And now we can have a look at our file structure inside the org directory. If I do it now, you see there is a data directory. And if I look at the data, you see it's going data, then data 08. That's the first two characters of this UUID. and then you get the rest of the UUID. So you see the file finally is stored on the data 08 and so on, and that's the UUID of your parent where you have set the attachment to inherit tag. So now we have done what we wanted to do. We have attached attached one file to our task. The nice thing is with this, if you have your task folder in a cloud space, you can easily synchronize those attachments between a lot of computers, because if you would put a link to your local file system, especially if I would put a link now to the temp directory, that would work now, and if I reboot the machine, the temp directory is going to be erased by a job when the machine boots up, and so the file would be gone. And what's also need to important or what's nice, if your directory where you keep your org files is a JIT repository, then every attachment is also automatically checked into JIT, and you can check it out or see the change log, whatever. But for this example, I don't have a JIT backup for my org files. I have it for my own personal system, and now when I was playing with those attachments, I have to confess I started playing with them a few days ago when my wife had a task that was filling out some forms for office and sent them. I was scanning the forms and I was putting them to the task as an attachment. So we are now here, we have our attachment. It's not a link, but you can open it by pressing O. So if we put ourselves on the task and we press O, something should happen. Hopefully. Yeah, this is a real live demo. Let me see if I press. Oh no. Of course, it doesn't happen when I press O here. I have to go to the dispatcher. Stupid me. Okay, Control C, Control A, and now I want to open that file, and you see my ghost view viewer opens and I see the org mode reference card. So, and I could do the same, but forcing the file to open in Emacs, that is Control C, A, Shift O, and you get the dog view buffer down here and you see it inside Emacs. Let me go back to this view. The next one for the attachment could be that you want to see inside the attachments directory. So you press Control C A F and you get a, you see we are now inside the directory and you see that org card PDF. Let me close that view. Okay, or we do the same with Control C A Shift F. Looks like that. Ah, and see. Oh, I was here, wait. C A Shift, no, C A, no, Control C, Control A, Shift F. You see now I'm at the org card, PDF, and if I press return, it opens again. I can close that file, and I can close that buffer, and then I'm here again. So this was opening and looking inside the directories. If you would have more than one attachment, if you open one, then IMAX asks you for a name. The other thing you could do is delete an attachment by Control CX. Control CA, And then the delete attachment, there is just one, that's all card PDF, but I don't delete it now. You could delete it, or you could do shift D, that's delete all attachments. One thing you could also do if you want to produce an attachment inside Emacs, you could press Ctrl C, A and N, then you name it my text at text, this is an attachment, and you see it's stored in home Joe 4b whatever. So if I close it, we can have a look at this. You see, no, that was the property 4b and so on, but hey, I should have an attachment here. Buffers. Okay. Control C A. No. C. Control A. Set. Okay. You saw I was storing an attachment in a buffer. I was saving it, and it didn't show up as an attachment until I said, okay, synchronized the task with its attachment directory. Then alt mode goes into the attachment directory and looks for attachments that are not yet here, and it attaches it to your file. So if I put control CX, nah, damned, control CA, shift O, you see, I end up in this attachment that I created in Emacs. So, that's all on the topic of attachments. It looks quite difficult here, but really it's quite easy, because you have to work maybe with the inherit flag if you have a project structure. The other thing, usually you just customize the variable org attach method. There you can choose between those four attachment methods, and then whenever you attach, you just press A for adding attachment, and it uses the file in this method that is configured in this variable. And the other thing you frequently need is opening attachments, and maybe deleting, and maybe synchronizing. If you could also copy files to that directory by hand and then synchronize again. So that's practically all what we need for attachment. It's quite a useful feature if you have to fill out forms, or if you, as I told you, if you want to synchronize between several PCs and your org files are in a cloud space, then it's a bit complicated to work with links to your file system that is not in the cloud space. So the easiest way is you create a copy as an attachment in your org directory, and you have everything that you want. The big difference to links is that it's not formatted as a link. There is no use in clicking on that file, there will nothing happen. But if you press O, like here, if C, A, I have an attachment, I want to open it, you see my attachment, my Ghost View PDF viewer opens, and there I can go. Okay, guys, that's all for attachments. I'm already talking too long, I see. Sorry for being so exhausting today. Thanks for watching, thanks for all the comments, and see you in the next video. You know, I'll be back.